if you were happier at work, you would improve mental health, your prospects at work, and more opportunities would come your way. But we're not happy, are we? We are miserable. Yet, we don't want to be part of this great resignation. Not yet, anyway. So, in this video, we talk about how you can feel happier at work, even if you hate your job. So let's understand the biggest reasons why you are miserable. And it's not the boss who you hate, or the crazy work hours, or your colleagues that you don't like. Those may be additional factors, but the three main reasons are: number one, you focus on what you don't want instead of what you want. Number two, you exert energy on things that you cannot control. Last week I talked about Catch-22, and as a result, I actually watched the whole series that is directed by George Clooney. I highly recommend that you watch it too. It's not only funny, it's deep as well. And John Jossarian, who is the main character, exerts an extraordinary amount of energy on things that he actually cannot control, rather than focusing on what he can do. And number three, your mindset shifted from learning to earning. What do I mean by that? See, when you started a new job, you were excited by the prospect of something new, a new experience and something that you could learn. But over time, you now believe that you have earned your place and the job, in a way, owes you. So how do we shift our mindset? Here are the three steps. Number one, have a plan, even a bad one. Imagine you get out of bed in the morning with no plan at all and there is nothing in the diary. How do you feel? Maybe relieved for a minute. But you also will feel a distinct lack of energy. But if you made a plan the day in advance, you know exactly what you are able to achieve during the day and your energy levels will be completely different. You don't have to have everything figured out. Start with any plan that's good enough, because the truth is we recognize very quickly when something is a bad plan and then we adjust, and that is far better than no plan at all. Number two, have a strategy. That's different from a plan. A strategy aims at something, and because it does, you have to think about the things that you have to do to get there, and that shifts your thinking towards things that you can control. Here are five ingredients of a good strategy. First of all, understand and define your problem. Find out what factors are affecting us. Decide which factors you want to tackle first and make a clear set of actions around them, and then define objective measures of success. Let me know in the comment section below when you want to hear more about this. Step three, focus on your contributions rather than what you want to get out of it. When you go to work in the morning with a clear mindset of what you can contribute at work, rather than thinking about what the company or the job owes you, then something magical happens. You start feeling proud. You feel that you can learn something, and because you learn something, your confidence in your own abilities increases. And because of that confidence, new opportunities arrive in your career and in your life. I wish that you get up in the morning full of energy, that you have a strategy that gets you through the day with a sense of growth and achievement, and that you grow your confidence that actually you are in control of your work life. Last week I talked about strategy in more detail, so you can either watch this next or speak to me directly, link in the description. I look forward to seeing you. Take care.